What up, world? Happy Friday. I am Deesa here with Pop Dust, and we got the man of the hour right here. His new album, Dancing Shadows, just dropped today. Ladies and gentlemen, the one, the only, Mario, brother man.
What up, what up, what up?
Thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule. I know it's been a crazy day for you. So, the new album, and night, the new album is out,
yes.
Dancing Shadows. It's fire. Give the people a little bit of background about the album if they haven't heard it yet.
Yeah, if you haven't heard this album, it's my first album in a while. My fifth album. Man, Dancing Shadows. The concept is a combination of just me curating ideas and aesthetics that has been inspired just throughout my musical journey, my musical influences. When you get the album, you're going to hear like the types of music I like, what I grew up on, what y'all grew up on. You know what I'm saying? Real music. And I really wanted to create something for the culture of music, of R&B, you know, that was classic, long-lasting, and something that people could really, you know, listen to and be inspired by. You know, I feel like my... I think my life and my walk has always been inspiring for a lot of my fans. And coming from Baltimore, like, I really feel like that's what's needed right now, you know. And, yeah, man, get into it. It's R&B. It's classic. It's motivational. You know, I got some sexy songs on there for the ladies. I got motivational music on there. I got music you need to come and see live, honestly. I made this record for my fans to come and see me perform live, like, when I go on tour, so. Yeah.
Definitely. And even the concept, Dancing Shadows, like if you listen to the album, it sounds like you're sitting in a room and it's like the album is moving around you as you listen to it, because it seems like you're just going from scene to scene and you're transitioning, but you're still in, you know, what I like to call the Mario room.
Yes.
When you're listening to it, is that something that you came up by design, or once you put the concept into play, it just took on a life of its own?
I think that's a really good description of the creative process, honestly. Like I said, just taking these different aesthetics. The album feels like what my life has felt like, just in terms of like having to start at a young age and then look back and look myself in the mirror to find myself. Like when you're an artist and you start so young, you can lose yourself in this shit. And it's like, you know, for me, I always wanted to keep that authenticity. No matter where I was in my career, and like having people that were more influential in the beginning, you know, writers and producers that pretty much wrote all my music, to transitioning into writing my own music and finding my own producers and creating my own vibes, to figuring out different concepts to talk about. Nah, these concepts are going to come from real life experiences. It's going to come from observing the world that we in today, you know, seeing where our people are in black culture today. Like, what type of motivation do we need? You know, I'm not a hip hop artist, but I'm a singer. So, you know, you think about Marvin Gaye, when he put out Mercy Mercy, put out What's Going On, like he was coming off of like his popular love songs into a more introspective place. That's where I feel like I'm at right now.
And you can definitely sense that with this album. And even with this album, you notice that R&B in a sense is kind of like the underdog when it comes to being a black voice, because you guys talk about love, you guys talk about being vulnerable, you guys talk about motivation. And with this album and you being through so much, I feel like you're at a place now as a man, as an artist, where you can express that and have it be your own voice. Do you see that being the tone of your music going on from here on out?
Yeah, I mean, I felt like this album needed to encompass a lot of, you know, questions that people may have, like, where you been, what you been. I feel like this album answers a lot of that, because I put so much creativity and energy into making sure that it had different dimensions. And all of those dimensions, I feel like I've kind of experienced growing up in industry, dealing with real life stuff. It wasn't like I'm just, you know, putting albums out every single year and just being a pop star. It's just like, nah, I'm living real life. I have something to talk about, you know, something that my fans can relate to. But moving forward, it's like I'm just keeping the same energy as far as observing my surroundings, you know, just coming from my heart. I don't know what's going to happen. We don't know, you know, so just stay tuned.
Definitely. And once again, we're happy that you're back. We're happy that a lot of people are really excited, and it's just a testament to the type of legacy that you have left in R&B. And we're more than excited about the album. It's amazing. So give the people some closing words.
Yeah, I just want to send a big shout out to all my fans, man. Honestly, I want to talk to y'all and tell y'all thank you for your patience. Thank you for your resilience. Thank you for, you know, growing with me through all these years, and now we here. You know, it's really about just motivation and staying creative. You know, we got a lot of power to change the world and influence people. So whatever it is your gift is, let that shit shine. You know what I'm saying? No fear, man. shoot for this, shoot beyond the stars. You feel me? And yeah, we're gonna keep motivated. Straight up.
Mario, thank you for your time. I know you got a busy schedule, so we're gonna get you out of here. Dancing Shadows is out now. Once again, from Mario, this is Decent for Pop Dust. Peace.
Hit him on the gram, Mario Worldwide.
Hit him on the gram, like you said. Peace, y'all.